Hey, how about a quick warm-up review, permutations, combinations, and of course, we had the snowstorm for 2 days, and we had that extended Easter break and all that, so I thought I'd just kind of recap some of the stuff in case you weren't following along there. Let's give her. All right, here we go. So, these were on the website. I'd issued these actually as well for some of you. Let's do this warm-up. Today's 19 April. Let's do these permutations. Remember that a permutation is an ordered arrangement of objects that you select from a larger group of objects. All right, so it's an ordered arrangement, and you're not allowed to take something out and then throw it back in. So it's an ordered arrangement of objects without replacement. It's a very common arrangement. All right, so let's do that one, and then we'll do two combination questions. So let's go. Here we go. So those are your warm-up questions. Well, there's two of them. And then here's some more warm-up questions. All right, so some dependent and independent probabilities. So there, that'll pretty much do all of what we did last week during the snowstorm and during the extended Easter break. So let's do the permutation part there. You ready? So it's a permutation. A permutation is an ordered arrangement of objects that you select from different objects, and you don't care what you do care what order they're in, right? Order does matter. And you don't get to choose one and then choose it again. You're only allowed to choose the item once. So let's just do the fundamental counting, right? He's got six different cars, and he wants to hook them up in some type of a train, and how many different ways could the train be created? So there'd be six choices, then five choices for the next car, then four, then three. All right, so that was pretty easy, right? It ends up being 360. You can do those almost in your head if you know your times table. That's called the fundamental counting principle. All right, the number of ways you can do different things is you count the number of ways to do each thing, if you're going to do them in some order, and then multiply them together. All right, or you could have just used the button on your calculator. Or you could have just looked at tables, right? I did give you tables in the back of the notes, too, if you didn't have a calculator on you. So the tables would tell you the answer. All right, how about this one? Here's a baby. Now, I hope you know that when you dial a phone number, the order does matter, right? You get somebody completely different if you don't put the digits in the correct order. All right, so phone numbers, the order does matter. So there's 10 digits on a phone, 0 to 9. Don't forget, 0 is a digit. So you got 10 different possible digits on a phone. And the baby's going to press them. But notice she only presses them once, right? Once she touches the one, she doesn't touch the other. She's kind of a weird baby, all right? So let's count the choices. Let's go to the fundamental counting principle, right? It said right there, there's no repeats. That means there's no replacing. All right, so let's count. There you go. So I get that many, all right? Look at that. There's 10 choices for the first button, then 9, then 8, then 7, then 6, then 5. So you multiply all those together and you'll get a honking big number. You know what? I'm just going to use the button on my calculator. 10 permute 6. So I've got 10 different things, and I'm going to select 6 of them in some order, and I'm not going to reuse them again. So there'd be 151,200, I like putting commas, different ways of doing it. There you go. All right. Let's do this one. Now, these are called combinations. Combinations, the order does not matter. And actually, combinations are probably more common for daily use than permutations. So in a combination, order does not matter. Right, so for example, here we go. Four names are just going to be randomly picked from a hat to be on a team. There are a total of 14 names in the hat. How many different combinations? A combination is an unordered arrangement of different objects. and we're just selecting a team. It doesn't say anything about we got to have somebody who's a goalie and somebody who's a forward. It doesn't say that there's a president and a vice president and a secretary. We're just grabbing a handful of students to make a volleyball team or something. All right. So we're just grabbing a team. It's a group. So there you go. It's a combo. 14 combo 4. There'd be 1,001 different teams you could make. And, of course, you know, one of the students is going, oh, I hope I'm not on the team with her. She's a pain in the butt. And then, you know, so, yeah, this is where you get all the conflicts. Say, oh, I hope I'm not on his team. You know, we could calculate the probability that you end up on so-and-so's team. You do this in your head all the time. You just didn't know you could do it with numbers. All right, how about there's 11 different marbles. I haven't lost my marbles. So we're going to take. It says take some marbles. It doesn't say select them in order and line them up on your shelf. It just says take some marbles. So take a handful. So that's a combo. It's going to be 330 ways. Sweet, eh? Next slide. All right, so that took care of perms and comms. All right, how about this one? Now, this is dependent and independent. So this is where we were finishing up dependent and independent events. Sometimes you do two things, and sometimes what you do on the first thing affects what you do on the second thing, and sometimes it does not. So this would be independent events. You're going to spin the spinner, right, and you're going to roll a die. So these would be independent, right? I hope you know that the outcome here is not affected by the outcome here. So the probability of spinning a white and then getting a 2 is, well, you just multiply them together. What's the probability of a white? And what's the probability of a 2? Well, I see one white out of a possible 4. And I see one, there's one 2 on the die right there out of a possible 6. There's 6 faces on a dice. There you go. 1 out of 24. That was tough, eh? There's the answer. Or you could have done it this way, right? You could have said, well, let's see. There was 4 possible things that could have happened here, which is 24 possible things. And then you could have said, and how many are what I want, right? So how many? So that would be the total number of possible things, 4 choices times 6 choices. And how many are favored? Well, there would be how many whites on there, right? There'd be 1 white. So there's 1 white and there's 1, so the favored ways for the white, there's 1 white and there's 1 2. Don't get confused with the 2 dots is not the same as the 1 choice. In any event, it works out that it would be 1 over 24. So what I'm trying to show you here is you could just do the counting method, right? You could just do the counting method and then calculate the top and the bottom. But most people like just using the fractions instead. All right, let's try hotel there. What's the probability you'll spin a black and then roll a 6? All right, so black and 6. All right, so I've introduced a new idea there. This symbol here looks like an upside-down horseshoe. That means and. Anytime you see something like that, that's just another way of saying and. So what's the probability of spinning a black and a 6? So let's do the math. Well, the standard formula is you calculate the probability of the black times the probability of rolling a 6. And guess what? 2 out of 4 times 1 out of 6. That looks like it's about 2 out of 24, which is really 1 out of 12 when you properly reduce it. Woohoo! Fun stuff, eh? So those were independent. Independent. Let's try dependent situations. Dependent is like this. All right, so dependent is, right, if you don't replace your marbles. All right, so we're going to draw a marble out from these 9 marbles. We'll draw out a marble. Then we're going to keep it in our pocket because we're not going to replace it. Or we're going to set it on a shelf or something. All right, so this is called dependent. So obviously what you do on the first draw, or the first event, will affect the second event. So the second draw is affected by the first draw. Obviously, right? If you take out a marble out of nine marbles, well, now there isn't nine marbles left over. There's only eight marbles. So let's do this. All right, so let's do Oscar there. The probability of a red, then a green. Or just, I like to say red, green. All right, so that's the probability of a red times the probability of a green. But here, we're not quite done here. The proper way to say it is the probability of red times the probability of a green, given that you already took out a red. So this makes it very clear to remind you that, by the way, when I calculate the probability of a green, I already used up a red. Because if you'd used up a different color, the number would be different. All right, so how many are red? 2 out of 9. All right, so you took out the first marble. There's 2 chances out of 9 that you pull out a red. Now, how many marbles are left? Well, you took out the red and it's in your pocket, so there's only 8 marbles left. And how many of those 8 marbles are green? Well, 4. So 4 out of 8. Uh-huh. And if you do that on a calculator, you end up with, 8 out of 72, which is obviously 1 out of 9. All right. So if you try this experiment a lot of times, one time out of every 9, you should expect to get a red then a green. Let's do whiskey here. The probability I pull out a green then another green. Uh-oh, be careful here. This is going to get tricky. The probability I pull out a green, then a green. All right, so whether you put the then in there or not doesn't really matter, as long as you understand the context of what you're doing. So the probability of a green times the probability of a green, given that you already used up a green. So the probability of a green on the first draw times the probability of a green on the second draw, given that you already used up a green on the first draw. Sometimes they put little ones and twos in here. And you end up with, well, let's see, how many greens are in there? 4 out of 9. And how many? So then I go to do the second draw. Don't forget, one of the greens is gone. You've taken it out and you've put it in your pocket. You have not replaced it. So how many marbles are left? 8 marbles are left. And how many greens are left? 3, because you took out one of the greens. Can you see how this gets really fun? All right, so it's 1 out of 6. So if you tried this particular game or set of events there, if you try this 6 times, you should expect that one time it will work out on average green then green. Sweet, eh? Woohoo! Well, that was fun. So hopefully that kind of catches you up with, 3 or 4 days of snow, blizzard, and Easter break complete.